students, welcome back. So in the previous class we have started with the chapter that is better around us pure, and we have seen that what is the meaning of pure according to chemist and according to the general people. And then we have seen the different types of pure substances. We have seen elements, compounds, that and we have seen impure one also, and we have seen the complete classification of the complete chemical classification of matter. Fine. Now today we'll start with the next part of it, that is mixtures. Now let's see what is mixture. As the name says, that it's a mixture. It means mixing of two or more substances. Fine, it's a mixture of two or more substances. But which substances? Any substance. As we are saying, it's impure. Impure according to chemist. Otherwise, it's not impure. It is also a kind of pure substance only. How? Let's see how. See, we are saying pure substance is that substance which consists of only one kind of matter. Fine. But mixture is that substance. It's a mixture of two or more pure substances. Or you can say two or more kind of matter. If we are saying matter is a pure substance, then it is also pure according to that. But here it's a mixture. Fine. So, mixture, it is defined as the substance consists of two or more kind of matter or pure substance. That is a mixture. Okay, and this mixture, you can say, it can be made by mixing substances in any proportion. Like, its proportion is not fixed, that how much we have to take. In any proportion we can mix the type of matter. Okay, take solid, mix into liquid, take liquid, mix into gas, take gas, mix into the another gas, like that. Take mix two solids, mix two liquids, like that. Fine, in any proportion, it's not fixed. We are not like you can say calculating its composition, and not in any proportion. But the compound which we have seen in the pure substances, that compounds can be made only in a fixed proportion. That's why its composition is fixed by mass. Otherwise, compound formation is not possible. And here, you can say mixture, this can be separated. Constituents of mixture can be separated by physical methods. We'll be dealing with this topic at the end of the chapter, the separation of mixture. So this is that only by physical method. We can apply physical method and we can easily separate the mixture. So this is about mixture. Now let's see, on the basis of its composition, based on its composition that we are talking about, it is of two types, nature of its composition. And in general, we can see before that what is mixture actually. Anything we are mixing, like you can say salt in water, sugar in water, lemonade, that is your nimbu pani. It's also a, all these are what? They are mixtures. Now we'll classify what kind of mixtures are they. Fine. And as we said that mixture can be separated by applying physical methods. So if we want to, suppose if we have formed the solution of salt in water and we want to separate that, it's very easy by evaporation. Evaporated, you will left with the salt and water will get evaporated. So it's easy to separate. So that's why we are saying it's possible to separate the mixtures by the physical method. Fine. So this can be separated by evaporation process. Now let's see its classification. Based on its based on its nature of composition. One is homogeneous, one is heterogeneous. Okay, homo means same and hetero means different. This different and same is related to the phase. Here only one phase, like only one phase remains throughout, either liquid, solid or gas. Fine, here different means two phases, like solid or liquid, liquid and gas, gas and gas, two gases, anything, whatever. Okay, phase means like it's related to the physical state. Phase is related to physical state of matter. So let's discuss now what are homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. Fine. So let's again classify them on the basis of its uniform composition. Homogeneous solutions will come. Solutions are the types of mixture. Heterogeneous, two types will come. One is suspension, one is colloid. Okay, these are the heterogeneous types of mixture. Now let's discuss what are the different types. So we'll start with the homogeneous mixture. Homogeneous mixture. So what is homogeneous mixture? As we are saying, it consists of only one phase. It consists of only one phase throughout. Okay, second, these are its characteristic properties. Second, you can say there is no visible separation of boundary between the two components. Okay, you will not be able to find that this is this substance and this is this substance. Once a mixer gets formed, you will not be able to identify that what you have mixed. Okay, so there is, you can say, complete uniformity throughout the throughout the mixture. So you can say there is a uniform composition throughout the mixture. Okay. Then next you can say it is stable. Why stable? As there is no boundary of separation. Fine. Now let's study all these with the help of example. Okay. So let's understand this, all these points with the help of example. Simplest example we'll take and then we'll move towards the chemistry part. Say salt in water. Fine. You have taken this is the, you can say, salt you have taken. Fine. This is the beaker. Here you have taken water. When you will add this salt into water, what will get formed? Solution gets formed. Now once the, this is the salt plus water, or you can say salt solution. Now this everyone has tried also and everyone knows also. But now you have to study its chemistry. Everyone knows when we dissolve salt in water, it gets dissolved. This also you have studied in first chapter also. We have seen that where that salts are, solute is going, it is going in between the spaces of the water molecules. Yes. Fine. So if it is going in between the spaces of the water molecules that we are saying matter, that particles of the matter, it is having space in between them. Yes. So after once, you can say after, once the solution gets formed, after that will you be able to see the salt? That salt is separate and water is separate. Will you be able to identify both? Only you will find complete solution, one complete phase, only liquid, no solid will be there. It means solute has been dissolved. So this is the meaning that, now this is the, you can say, no separation of boundaries, no two boundaries are there, only one complete uniform phase is there. Yes, so you can see uniform composition that we have seen. And due to this also, solution is stable. See, it is stable. Once it has formed, it's stable in nature. It will not break down or salt will not settle down and all. So, this is the meaning of homogeneous mixture. So, let's talk about the solution. That is a homogeneous mixture. Similarly, when you will take copper sulfate crystals. Okay, small crystals you will take and then dissolve in water. What you will get? Copper sulfate crystals gets dissolved. You will get its solution, which is blue in color. Because as this is blue in color. So this is a solution. Again, you will not find any separation of boundary. You have seen so many solutions are kept in the lab. Some are red, green, of different colors. So you will not be able to identify which salt is this. If you know the salt, the color of that, so then only you will be able to identify. Otherwise, the salt will not be able to see that whether it is, that salt is separated out from the water. So it's uniform. So let's talk about solution now. What is solution? Homogeneous mixture that we have to study, that is solution. Solution is the term for the homogeneous mixture. Now, solution is, you can say, it is a homogeneous mixture of two or more substances. Okay, and the solution we are going to discuss, that is binary solution. Binary means two. So it consists of two components. One is solute and one is solvent. So let's see what are this. What is solute and what is solvent. Fine. So we'll be dealing only with the binary solution. If more than two components are there, then it is known as ternary. Ternary means three. So let's talk about solute and solvent now in detail. It's very, very important. What is solute and what is solvent? Solute. Solvent. Okay, so solute is, it is the component of solution which is present in lesser amount, and solvent, it is the component of solution which is present in more amount. More amount. So whatever is present, you will come to know by its amount. If it is lesser in amount, it means it is a solute. If it is more in amount, it means it's a solvent. So we need solute so that it gets dissolved in a particular solvent. Okay, so let's say example, salt in water. Now we know that we'll take salt only a pinch and water will be present in the more amount, 100 ml we are taking or any other amount. So salt is a solute and water is a solvent and we are getting solution. That is salt solution. Okay, so can we say that solution consists of two components, solute plus solvent? If I take any other example, say that say tincture of iodine. Iodine. Tincture of iodine is used as an antiseptic. Okay, and it's a, you can say it's a mixture of or solution of mixture of iodine in alcohol. Okay, where iodine acts as the solute and alcohol acts as the solvent. So this is the meaning of solute and solvent. And so many examples you can consider and find out what is solute and what is solvent. This you can do. Okay, try it. Find out the solute, what is the solvent. Okay. So let's see the next part of this. We have seen solute, solvent. Now on the basis of this only, on the basis of amount of solute and solvent, solution, it is of two types. One is dilute solution, one is concentrated solution. Dilute means that more amount of solvent is there. Dilute solution means less solute, more solvent. Here, more solute means more concentrated. More solute, less solvent. Now, this I will relate with the example that you have seen so many acids are there in the lab and we have labeled them as dilute acid, concentrated acid. Then what is the difference between the two? Fine. So let's see if I take the example of that. It's very, you can see, you will easily get understood by this example. Easily get understand. So if I take acids. Acids, we are saying dilute, HCl, concentrated HCl. Dilute HCl means that percentage of acid is less. For example, if I say 50% acid is dilute, it means let's say it's 38% or 40%, let's say 40% HCl. And if I take 99% HCl. Okay, so 40% HCl means 40 HCl and rest is 60 is water. 40% water, 40% HCl, 60% water. And here 99% HCl and 1% water. Now just see the difference. If I say which one is more corrosive, which one is having more corrosive action, you will say concentrated. It is having more amount of the acid. So that's why you can say solute is more. HCl is the solute here. HCl is the solute here and water is the solvent here. So this is the meaning of the solute and solvent. And on the basis of that, we have seen two different types of solutions are there. Fine, I think what is solution, what are the its components and what is the mixture? I think it's clear to everyone. Okay, so here you can say if you are taking solute and solvent. Solvent is, you can't say it's always water. It can be other also. It can be solid also. It can be gas also. Like you know that air is a mixture of gases. Okay, let's consider this. Air is a mixture of gases. But which mixture? Homogeneous or heterogeneous? This is the question here. As we know that air is a mixture of so many gases. Air is a homogeneous mixture. Mixture of gases. Why homogeneous? As only gas is present, only one phase. Okay, only one phase is there. So that's why it's a homogeneous mixture. Like what is present? Nitrogen is present, oxygen is there, water vapors are there. Then what else? Then you can say trace in trace amount other gases are present. So this is a mixture of air. That is, air is a mixture of gas. Nitrogen is there, oxygen is there, water vapors are there, and other gases are there. Fine. And we know that nitrogen is more in atmosphere. It is around 78% and oxygen is 21% and rest are gases. Yes, rest percentage are gases. So can we say that this is more in amount? So this is a solvent here. Here it is less solute. Other gases, they act as a solute. So this is, you can say, it's a kind of gas by gas mixture or gas by gas solution. So this is the meaning. Solid and gas is also possible. We'll discuss later on all these kind of examples. So this is very important here. But what is air? Homogeneous or heterogeneous? I hope it's clear to everyone now. What is solute here? What is solvent here? So this is all about the solution. In the next class, we'll see what are its different characteristics, properties, and how to find out the different compositions and all. Fine? Till then, thank you and have a nice day.